The Fillet tool now provides options to apply asymmetric radius values to fillets. Check the asymmetric option to add a second radius value to a radius fillet. Use the toggle to flip which side each radius is on. The new partial fillet option allows you to control how much of the edge is involved in a fillet feature. Check the partial fillet option while completing a radius fillet. You can enter the offset in the first and second bound locations or set the distance in the graphics pane.
Previously, adding a section to a part studio or an assembly with an existing section required turning off that section before adding additional sections. With this improvement, users can now edit a section to modify an existing section or add additional planes to create new sections by selecting Edit Section View. If Section View is not turned off and the dialog box is closed, open the dialog again by double-clicking on the section plane. Alternatively, click the View Cube menu or right-click on the part or assembly to access the context menu and select Edit Section View.
During a period of inactivity, Onshape will automatically close the connection to the active session. With this release, you may now simply reconnect at the click of a button, allowing you to get directly back to working without having to refresh the browser window and reload the model. With this release, you will notice that the My Onshape filter has been changed. At each different license level, you will instead find an ownership first view of the data you have access to as a part of your account. Free and standard users will see an owned by me filter as the default experience. Therefore, only documents owned by these users will be shown here. Professional users will see group data owned by the company or companies they are a part of and a filter named for each of those organizations. In rare cases, when a professional user owns some documents themselves, an owned by me filter will also be present. Enterprise users will now see the enterprise name clearly labeled and will filter for documents data owned by that enterprise. The other navigation filters, including recently opened, created by me, shared with me, and teams, have not been altered and will continue to function as you will expect.
Having a sheet number column is helpful on the inspection list report. With this improvement, a column will list the sheet number where each item number, annotation, or dimension is located. The sheet number column will be immediately to the right of the item number column. This release has brought the ability to adjust automatic center marks. Users can now alter the length of manual or automatic center mark lines and enable extended lines. To accomplish this, hover over a center mark line to display the grip points at the end of each line. Click and drag one of the grip points outward or inward and drop at the new position. Notice all the lines move simultaneously. To move one line independently, hold Shift and then drag and drop.
The Style panel now supports the editing of flag notes and other callouts. Selecting these callouts, you can easily change the font, text size, color, and arrowhead.
Thanks for watching. Click the logo to subscribe or see some of our other videos linked here.